renowned Qigong master. He is author of The Master Key and founder of Robert Peng Qigong. He has taught at Esalen, Omega, Kripalu, and many other organizations. Happy to have you with us, Robert. Hello.
Oh, thank you, Dandi. Thank you. Happy to see you here. It's been a while.
Yes, well, I'm so happy to see you. And I want to ask about Qigong, really getting to the basics. Tell us exactly what it is, what it's like, and really how it originated.
Well, Qigong, Qi itself is like an energy force, or they say it is the most essential part of the energy that made the world. So it can be even smaller than atoms, than the smallest particle of that. Yeah. So we call it the fine energy, or the light, vital force. Actually, this Qi is not just Chinese culture. You know, in India, they call it prana. Yeah, just call it different. In Egypt, they call it Kai. In Japan, it's called Reiki. You know, Reiki, I don't speak Japanese, but if I read Reiki, it sounds to me as a Chinese, meaning spiritual qi. Yeah. So that's the energy that make us as what we are. You know, we're all made of the atoms, the molecules, the same thing, but why me, Robert, and you, Dandi, or any other else, they look different. Their personalities, their characters are totally different, coming from the same material. Is in what we understand, the qi is different. So the cultivating of the qi, we call it qigong. Yeah, the art to cultivate the life force is qigong. And the qigong's qi and tai chi's qi, some people ask, what is tai chi, what is qigong? Actually, these two words are totally different. Tai chi's qi means polarity. When you go to the extreme, then you should move towards the other side, like yin and yang. Now it's middle of the day, in the eastern time, it is extreme yang. So after this, you're moving towards the yin part, which is the night. Yeah. So that is what tai chi means. Tai chi, when they move, they never move in the direct way. They move in the round way. This round way are following the rules of yin and yang. So they have a saying, if you do tai chi, because tai chi is very martial artist. They kill people, but they don't kill people by killing people, by hitting them. They kill the people by exhausting them, because they're so good at manipulating the energy, yeah, yin yang energy. So they're like manipulating your movement. So you want to stop, you can't, because you're off the balance. You're moving back and forth, and left and right. So that is what tai chi's qi. Qigong's qi is the force, it's life force. And it goes greatly a lot with our breathing, with our mind, with our body movement. So starting Qigong or practicing Qigong, we say you should start with three alignment or adjustment. The three of them are adjust your breathing, adjust your mind, adjust your posture. And with this three together, a simple movement or just sitting meditation can work hugely internally to balance our energy and to empower our energy center. So that's briefly what Qigong means. Yeah, actually we can have a little game to feel how the Qi goes. You know, if you take out the line, take out the hands and look at the line on the wrist, and you match them together, find they're the same length, all right? Now you put down your right hand, rest on your left. Keep your left fingers straight and relaxed. Now don't do anything, just thinking, left fingers are growing longer, 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 stretching out, shooting into the sky, getting deep into the earth, into the universe. Keep shooting. Feel the feelings between the joints of the left fingers. Grow, 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 grow. Now, take out the right hand again. match them together. See, they're different, all right? The mapping can grow longer. So, just now we didn't shake our hands or pull in fingers with other hands. What we did was just thinking. So thinking of moving our body through the mechanics of qi. Yeah, so qi is the energy flow inside the body and it stores in different places. First, it stores in all our organs. All our organs are the big warehouse of the qi. And to be connected with all these organs, we have three energy centers. We call it Dan Tian. D-A-N-T-I-A-N. Dan means elixir. Tian means fuel. Elixir fuel. We have three of them. One is in the middle of the eyebrows, in the center of the head. We call it upper Dan Tian. Upper Dan Tian. When the energy here is strong and healthy, you feel guided. Like we make a decision or you are going to do something. It's always like a guidance guides you to do things well, to move in a good direction. Yeah. It's like you have good GPS inside your head, right? In life. Yeah, you're driving your life's car and you know when to turn, when to stop. When there's a red light, when there's a green light, go smooth. Yeah. In other words, when your energy here in your upper Dan Tian is strong and healthy, you are wise and intuitive. So when the energy here is weak and not so healthy, underdeveloped, then you get very confused. Yeah, you may do things in a very wrong way. So that's upper Dan Tian. Another energy center is in the middle of your chest. Yeah, the center, the entrance is the center of your chest. And if you have the energy here and strong and healthy, you feel loving and love. Yeah, it's like you're having the Buddha heart. Yeah, Buddha heart, compassionate. Yeah. But when the energy here is weak and underdeveloped, then this Buddha heart becomes like fragile, lost heart. You feel hurt easily, you feel sad, you feel depressed. Yeah. So healthy middle Dan Tian, you are loving and compassionate. Yeah. When it's weak and unhealthy, then you are quite impotent. Yeah. Impotent of feeling the good qi and presenting the good qi. You know, loving and love, or sending and giving, in terms of energy, they come together. Yeah, many people think, oh, you know, they complain to their children, I sacrifice everything, I love you so much, and you don't love me. Yeah, well, in terms of energy cultivation, it is still not complete. But when it's complete and healthy, living, giving and loving happens at the same time. Yeah, in my workshop, there's one practice we call name chanting. We have one of the students lying or sitting in the middle, and then we have 20, 30 people chant his or her name. You don't need to say anything. Just through the vibes of the chanting, you're sending the healing qi and the loving qi. Everybody feels instantly the loving qi sent up, bounce back even stronger. Yeah. So that is the middle Dan Tian, the loving center. Then in the lower torso, in the center there, it holds the energies of vitality. So when your energy here is strong and healthy, you feel vital. Yeah. You don't want to stop. You're always, you know, feeling juicy, feeling like to do something. You know, a little boy or girl, especially teenagers or earlier, because they have such a good vitality, they don't stop. Well, they stop when they're tired. They close their eyes, they sleep, they wake up, they move again. But when energy here is weak, because it's connected with kidney, qi, bladder, all this, we call this whole area extended sexual part. Yeah. So it holds the energy of sexuality, the birth power. You know, if you have qi strong here, you're 100 years old, you can still have a baby, right? Healthy baby. So that is the vitality. Yeah. So So when qi strong is healthy here, you're dynamic, you're action oriented. Yeah. When it's weak, then it's quite hard for you to move physically. Yeah. You have poor health. And also it's very hard to make things happen. Yeah. Say for example, someone who's so developed with upper dantian, strong upper dantian, very clever, if they make decisions, well, it can be leading very, very greatly. But if they have a very poor lower dantian, lower torso, no matter how beautiful the idea is, they cannot make it happen. Armchair professor is what we call it, right? Armchair professor. You have a million ideas, but you cannot move a step. Yeah. That is the problem, because we have all the three dantians, then they are sometimes not moving harmoniously. Another example is like, you may have someone who is very, have big heart, you know, loving, compassionate, but if here the upper dantian is weak and underdeveloped, they can be, if you have a friend or neighbor like this, they can be very loving and adorable neighbor, but meanwhile, annoyingly, they may knock at your door at midnight, waking you up from deep sleep and telling you very excitedly how to cope with your insomnia. It's the wrong time, because they don't have a good GPS or a good intuition to guide them to go right direction, right timing. How about the opposite? Upper dantian strong and healthy, lower dantian poor and underdeveloped. This one, if they make business, they may be very successful, they can be very rich, but no matter how rich, how successful their career is, here is blocked, they don't feel happy. I have a lot of patients, they're so rich, actually, but they come here for depression. Some of them are going so deeply that they don't feel the meaning of life. Yeah. And so all this kind of different structures of the energy pattern, when it is not compensated to each other, then you may feel that you are suffering. Yeah, you're suffering. So another, for example, like if you have upper dantian very strong, lower dantian weak, you are in the army and your commander, your officer is this type, yeah. Upper dantian weak and lower dantian strong, then I suggest you flee as soon as you can. Yeah. Because they don't think well. Yeah. They take actions before they think. You're gonna die without knowing why. Yeah. So all this type, in my book, the Master Key book, I elaborate, analyze six typical types. Yeah. They all have something that is missing energetically. Then we suffer. Yeah. It doesn't mean necessarily any particular person. It can be in our own situations for some time. Like, well, for this half year, I just feel so foggy, right? Anything, decision I make, it's just like, fail. Then maybe I need to empower my upper dantian. We're not teaching here, we have a practice of a program called empowerment, the upper dantian, the middle dantian, the lower dantian, the empowerment. Well, the more important thing is that they should move harmoniously. It's like, you know, we have all the organs, we have three dantians, and it is like you have a team of 12 people. If they are all moving in one direction, then you have a good team, right? It is effective, it is efficient, and it's healthy. But if one of the members want to go to the right and the other want to go left, and you want to move forward, then as a whole team, you suffer. As a whole body, you suffer. Every single cell or organ, individually, they can be healthy, but as a holistic one, you suffer badly. Yeah. So the Qigong practice, actually, in one way, is ways to harmonize them. The three steps or three functions to practice Qigong. One is Jingqi in Chinese, meaning purification. When you practice in Qigong, you make your energy even more purified. You know, we're bound with tremendous power of energy. In my master's work, I say everybody is bound to reach, like a gold mine. Yeah. But if you don't cultivate them, they are contaminated, they're not so pure, then the organs, the cells, they're not sufficiently awakening, then you begin to get old, you can be just getting ill. So one thing is purification through all kinds of ways of breathing, meditation, movement, purify the energy along the meridian. Then the second function or second step is concentration. So once it is purified, it's a lot easier for them to be concentrated, following your mind very sharply. You know, I have a practice I teach, especially young students, because they love this show. It's like, we call it hard Qigong. After half a year of dedicated concentration of practice, your energy are so purified, then they hold together so much easier. Then we bring attention to your throat here. We bring a chopstick or spear, you can break it. Yeah, you take a little a piece of brick, you can smash on your head and still safe, yeah, because all the energy are purified in the swamp here when it's needed, yeah. So the concentration is like laser, you know, laser. Laser is just light, right? Light. When we have the light to feel any pressure at all, it is beautiful energy. But once it is concentrated into one beam, thousands of beams together, they cut through, right? Even the diamond, that's how powerful the concentration of energy is. Then the third is, we say, just coming right when your concentration happens, your potential energies are manifested. Yeah. The potential energy can be a potential energy of healing, your clairvoyance, your wisdom, yeah, your strength of the body, your intuitions, these are all your potentials. Yeah. Some people are developed with some certain potential, some are the others. Yeah. But these are not something from celestial, from outside. It is hidden inside our potential reservoir. Yeah. And when the energy can trigger all that potential switches, then they begin to release and serving us, yeah. And because our energy are like the cells of the brain, we're using very tiny percentage of it. We're bound with tremendous powerful energy and we're dying with that. It doesn't go into our service. So the practice of Qigong is awakening them. So it's like you begin to open your a bank account, yeah. Before you have bank account, but you lose your ID, you forget your password, you go to the bank, and you don't have the money, they won't give you. Yeah. But once you have all this equipped, then that money, actually that energy, will serve you. Yeah. So that's the three elements of the Qigong, the function of the Qigong. And, you know, we are human beings, me too. We have we have good days, we have bad days, and if you practice in Qigong every day, then every day can be a good day, right? Because they make the adjustment all the time. And especially there's another energy channel besides upper, middle, and lower dantian. It's called the central meridian. The central meridian is the energy channel that connects top head here and with the perineum, crossing all three dantians and connecting all the way to the heaven and the earth. So this central meridian is the one to make us connect with the universal energy. Yeah, universal energy. And it also helps to harmonize all the three dantians. Yeah. So when Dong be shy, yet when you bring your awareness to your central meridian's energy channel, you become to be the center of the universe. Because all what we have around us is the manifestations of what we think. Our mind creates the whole world. We have central meridian anchoring your energy, then the whole universe are centering around you. You are the center of the universe. That's how we can make Qigong benefit us to be the real. That's how we can use the Qigong to benefit us to be the real master of our own life. Yeah, that's why in the Taoism, the sage, in the ancient time are called Zhenyuan, meaning true person. We're not true person, right? Yeah, the true person is that you can fully make use of what you have. Yeah, now it is using only 5% or 6%, so we're not true person. Yeah, true person should be at least use 40%. Einstein used maybe 12%. He's a genius, right? Yeah. So that's some random talk about what qi is. And the upper dan tian, because it's concentration of the energy, then the whole area is like a house to hold this dan tian. Yeah. And this house that holds the dan tian, we call it wing, because the energy inside, they're not just simply glowing, they are moving in, like in the galaxy, they're moving all different patterns. They can spin, they can rotate, they can make figure eight. So we call this area Wheel of Wisdom. Then the area that houses the middle dantian, Wheel of Love. Then the lower dantian over there, the house of the kidneys, perineum, and navel all together form a cauldron. We call it the Wheel of Vitality. Then the central meridian, because it's connected with heaven and earth, crossing three dantians, we call it the Wheel of Harmony. Yeah, harmony. So these, because they are so beautiful, so powerful, my master put an adjective and named this four areas as four golden wheels. Yeah. Golden wheel of wisdom, golden wheel of love, golden wheel of vitality, golden wheel of central meridian. Right. So these are the basically what Qigong is and how it helps.
Robert, thank you. Thank you for all of that, explaining to us the dantians, which are so important for cultivating health and joy and happiness, and this central meridian which runs through all of the dantians, and also explaining for us the difference between Tai Chi and Qigong, and that the Qi in Tai Chi and the Qi in Qigong are very different, and that Tai Chi is more of a martial art and Qigong is more of a healing art. So thank you for that. I know you have many healing techniques. Can you teach us a healing technique in this session?
Sure, yes. There is a beautiful healing technique to balance our emotion, to make our emotions free of the trouble. Yeah. You know, we are we're human being. Yeah, again, yeah. Something happens or something not happen, but all our internally, there's always something tumbling around. Yeah. Every now and then we can feel happy, then we can feel sad, we can feel angry. Yeah. It is okay. Yeah, that we feel all this. Yeah. Angry, sadness, you know, frustrations. That is like five elements of our cooking, right? Or our spice that make our life rich and colorful. But the thing is that you should be able to control it. This is like your own tool. But the thing is that because all these emotions are so addictive and manipulated, many times we are controlled by our emotions. Yeah. compare it like your pet, you know, when you're walking the dog on the New York City street, right? Yeah, at first you think you're walking a dog, then in the end you find the dog is pulling away of you. Yeah, you're walked by the dog. Yeah, when you're driven by emotions, then you are suffering a lot. So first, don't be frustrated that you have some emotions. Second, we want to be the master of emotions. Yeah. So anytime we have some emotions, you can tap this to make it balance. Yeah. And before that, this practice, the chanting, is that chanting goes with the tapping. Yeah. The chanting is song kung tung bing quan yun. Song kung tung, this is all om sound. It's quite void. Song kung tung means open, loose, letting go, void. Yeah. So it's positive ways of getting free. Yeah. Then bing quan yun is that any imbalance will be balanced again. Will be any problem will be healed again. Any disease will be cured. That means bing quan yin. Bing means imbalance or sickness. Quan yin means recover. So you chant song kung tung bing quan yin. Song kung tung bing quan yin. That's the chanting. Then we're going to work on the central meridian to activate the harmony channel. So you just have on here, song kung tung bing quan yun, song kung tung bing quan yun, song kung tung bing quan yun, song kung tung bing quan yun. Normally you do about 9 of them, yeah, 9. Then you tap the upper dantian in the middle of the eyebrow, yeah, inhale. About 9 of them. Then you tap the loving chi center, yeah, in your lower torso, in the middle of your chest. Go song kung tung bing quan, song kung tung bing quan, song kung tung bing quan. Right, about 9 of them. So then the next one is your lower torso, your lower dantian. Yeah, it's about 3 fingers below the navel. It's the navel. So you tap song kung tung bing quan, song kung tung bing quan, song kung tung bing quan. About 9 of them. You take a deep inhale and exhale and see how it feels. Yeah, there's a simple formula to do this. If something happens, you know, some people are very strong phobia. They are afraid of claustrophobia, afraid of getting in the elevator, or they are afraid of cockroach, or height, or you're in a severe anger, yeah. All this kind of extreme emotions. If that happens, you can have, first step, you can have like a very rough evaluations. What is the stage of this? If it is 10, you're gonna die, you're gonna kill them, right? That's the extreme. If it is 0, you're totally fine, yeah. So 5 is in the middle. So you give a rough ideas of what degree is that you're gonna work on here. Take deep inhale. Song kung tung bing quan yin. Yeah, that's 9 of them. Song kung tung bing quan yin. 9. 9 in the middle chest, you lower than middle dantian, then lower dantian. So each one in 9 sets, then take a deep inhale. And you watch your issue again. 100%, it drops. Yeah, it drops. It may drop 2%, 20%, or some people get all the way to 0. Yeah. If it is still like not satisfied, it still have 20% or 30% left. Repeat it again. Yeah. Then you're like driving a super powerful four-wheel drive. No, whether the road is bumpy or slippery or snowy, you have a way to drive it through calmly and smoothly.
Robert, that's so powerful for people who have really overwhelming emotions or phobias. Thank you for sharing that. I think that a lot of people don't realize that Qigong is a healing art and it can heal us both physically and emotionally. How can people find out more about Robert Peng Qigong?
Oh, thank you. Well, very simply is going to my website, robertpeng.com. Yeah, then we have all the information of my workshop, my books and CDs and my online course. And for the healing techniques, I have a 2-week healer's course in August this year in Omega. And also I have just finished in Kripalu long weekend, the Master Key course section, mainly talking about and practicing about the spoken wheels. So yeah, the simple way is go to my website, yeah, robertpeng.com. Thank you.
Wonderful, wonderful. Thank you. And is there one last thought that you would like to leave the viewers with today?
Enjoy your four golden wheels. Yeah, tap new energy into your four golden wheels and have a beautiful life all the time.
Thank you so much, Robert. Thank you for this session today. And thank you for all of our viewers being with us today. And we will see you again soon.
Thank you, Dandi. Thank you for having me here. I had a wonderful time. Thank you.
Thank you for joining us for the Energy Medicine and Healing Summit, brought to you by the Shift Network. You can add every teaching and transcript to your personal library by visiting energymedicinesummit.com/upgrade. To learn more about awakening to your full potential and together co-creating a world that works for all, visit theshiftnetwork.com.